Well, right now we're about to take a brief interlude in our hunting and gathering, just to take in some of the scenery. We've got these fjords that are dropping out of native bush, and this is like a wall that's dropping straight down to 200 meters, and I'm just going to go for a cruise along the edge of that wall and see what I can see. Maybe grab a crayfish. Maybe. It's not often I get a chance to strap bottles on the back and go for a scuba dive, and I mean, what better place to do it? I mean, it's Fielder National Park, and the scenery for me is better underwater than what we're seeing above the water. So strap the bottle on, drop in the water. The vis isn't great, but I'm seeing things that you just don't see. I mean, there's black coral, you're seeing these big blue cod cruising around, and of course crayfish. There's crayfish everywhere, and as much as, you know, as I'm trying to look at other stuff, I can't help but look at these crays. Then we come across one crack, and there's this big eel in there, big conger eel. And I know these things grow pretty old, you know, very old. So you're thinking all of those years, you know, this could be a 100-year-old eel that I'm eyeballing here. And I start to realise I'm not sure who's more interested in who here. This eel's really checking me out. And part of me is saying, wow, I want to really get close in and check this guy out. And we're just eyeball to eyeball. And then I remember that, well, they can bite pretty hard. So I don't get too close, but I manage a little brush on the chin. And I wouldn't say that I've ever had a close connection with a fish other than wanting to catch it. But it's about as close as it would come.